Okay. Hi, it's going well. I'm just setting up. I just realized my black table is not a good place to construct a black butterfly potty. How's it going with you? I think this audio isn't going through. It's gonna be the monarch butterfly. Looking like this. I'm doing this right now because I usually construct this with a certain weight of cardstock, and I accidentally bought a heavier weight than I usually get. So I need to make sure that this model is still doable with this heavier weight, or else I'll not be able to use it and need to buy different cardstock. So my background music isn't coming in, right? Let's see. Weird. Not exactly sure how all this works yet, sorry. How's that audio? This is a much quicker build than the gecko, though it's still a little bit of a trial to get through the wings because it's each wing is three layers of paper. Makes it so, yeah, it works out. So how are you doing today? Ooh, is it working again? It's being a little stubborn, huh? So far, yeah, I think I need to go ahead and get that lighter cardstock again instead of using this, because just to make it easier on people who put these together. Well, it's just $10. It's just still a pain to spend more money. When this tougher cardstock was 15. But it's not too much for me to put together, and could always use more butterflies. Thank you. I think what I'm gonna do is finish the head on this one and then just set it aside because the wings will take a while to do and I'd rather get to design. I mean, you can see that this is the final product anyways. This layer is one, so it's the black is on both sides and then it's just the orange in between. So when you hold it up to light, you can see through it a little bit. So it's really pretty. Think looks like I misplaced one of my tools already, but I'll just use a different one. Yeah, it's pretty cool what paper can do. Yeah, this paper's more stubborn than I want it to be. Ugh. I'll figure out another use for it. Yep, that's the body there. So for the wings, I have these cut out. And they go on top like that. Just gonna set it aside for now. So, let's see what I have for designs. So what I'm making at the moment, let me change this. There's some older designs for Ladybug. I'll rip this one out. Pardon, I had a paper. Oh, I did that in my little notebook. I was like, where did it go? Let me see. I put I need to go get a different sketchbook. I'll be right back. Well, I was planning to do finger puppets, but maybe we should just work on something else then. I'm planning a Pokemon card. It's for Ginkgo. It's not exactly my Kirigami. I mean, pop-up cards are by their nature Kirigami, but it's not exactly one of my Thank you. Yeah. This will be like white vellum, and this will be red vellum, and then underneath them will be a half and half paste black Bulbasaur silhouette. And then when you open up the card, and then there's gonna be two flaps that'll come down here. And then when that happens, the Bulbasaur will pop out. Think what I can do then. I don't know where that sketchbook went. I swore it was in this one, but it wasn't. It's in a tiny green sketchbook, and it could be in one of my bags. So instead, we'll get to a blank paper and design something else. How about that frog? Or do you have a herp you're interested in? Herps, as in frogs and toads and lizards and turtles, stuff like that. Have anything you're interested in? Maybe we can just make something new this time. What's your favorite herp? It's like or frogs and toads and lizards and turtles. Okay, do you have one in general a bit? Like, what should I make right now? A frog or a toad or a turtle or a lizard? Yeah, dart frogs, sure. Dart frogs have like usually tiny little arms and then like full-on frog legs that go back and look alien and stuff. So go bodies, and they're very tiny frogs in general. The first, I'm just gonna sketch the frogs. The frog from different angles. And then I'll pull out my colored pencils, and I'm gonna add where, basically what the it'll look like once it's made of paper. And proportions, and then I'll draw it out flat.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, when I'm pretty good at drawing from a reference. I should just get out my thing, so. Thank you. Well, there's my sketchbook. Okay, welcome back to that. There's the leopard gecko design. Okay, so I'll cut this out in a second. I made the body too short, and the proportions of the arms are going to need to be adjusted too. But shape's more important than that, so it's no biggie.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's sweet to say. I'm doing something a little bit weird here. I made the toes backwards accidentally. And that's probably just it. Okay. Hmm. proportions actually turned out a bit better than expected, but I still need to shorten this arm a little bit. And get this focused. There we go. That's all I did. Whoops. Okay. That's a good first draft. It probably won't take many drafts to make this. But let me do the bottom part. Okay, I don't know if that was just two or something, but are you there? Think you're my sole viewer today.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, I just cut out the bottom half and then added these eyes for the bottom. Nice to have you back, soul viewer. I do appreciate it. What do you think about the difficulty level of this? Like, do you think if I made instructions, you could recreate this? Or, I mean, like, once I actually have a kit and it's all cut out. For the final one, it'd be cardstock and using glue. Not, yeah. Yeah, or for the instructions, I have it step by step and full color images. It's just basically something like this, or only with me taking pictures every so often. The reason I'm asking you is basically because, well, I don't know for sure if you did do origami before this, but, basically, yeah, because, I want to know if people who are amateurs, I guess, are just going at it, if they'd be able to complete it. Yeah. Paper doesn't score very well on. the drawing, like the red on it, the models that I send out, well, I mean, the paper that I send out is like all scored, pre-scored. So the scores are there already. You would have an image of the final piece, like, I mean, so you'd have that kind of reference. I don't mean to put any pressure on you. It's just because it's what I'm considering when I'm designing these. If somebody who's, you know, never done it before, or could they do it? Could they make it? Am I making it too difficult for people? Sorry about that. Okay. Okay, cool. I do this part with tape because then I can just unstick it and fold it flat back out, and then I can remark where I added more creases and stuff like that and just take another picture. Because after this part, I use the picture and basically remake it on using Instinct, using Inkscape. I really did that, huh? I've seen a little bit of red versus blue. Do you like Halo in general? So you got Twitch Prime Gaming there. So what kind of games do you play? Yeah, makes sense. Sorry, need a second to figure out what the heck I'm doing here. I'm gonna make this tape less sticky at this rate. Yeah, that makes sense. I like games like that too. I like, though, to be honest, my favorite kind of games are multiplayer. I don't like first person shooters very much, but like about everything else. I mean, shooters in general, well, I love Splatoon. Haven't played it that much, but it's a lot of fun. And Splatoon. It's that Yeah, that's fun. Think Nintendo owns part of my soul or something at this rate. I like a lot of their games. Made this piece a little bit long. Yeah, see, I'm gonna need to redesign this part. I think the rest of it is turned out pretty good proportionally. And yeah, the tape just stopped being sticky on that one. Okay. So without that eyepiece, the mouth is hanging open like this. I also need to, this arm has fallen off. So I need to figure out that proportion a little bit better of how much is cut. So people are gonna be losing froggy arms. And then, and I think I'm gonna narrow the mouth, the bottom jaw right here slightly. And just keep it mostly flat. And then on this bottom jaw right here, let me get a pencil. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna extend this a space between right here and have it so the jaw is folded back onto itself like this, and that way the jaw will be a little bit more mobile and it won't end up being so straight like this. That way you can open up the mouth a little bit, and I'll also reinforce that shape that frogs have at the throat. Some of the weirdness that's going on is that this is made out of flimsy paper instead of cardstock, so it doesn't hold the shapes as well as it would be if I made it out of cardstock. But that's just how the drafts go. Yeah, here's our frog first draft. Quite a bit more to do, but I'm not going to do it right now because it's a lot of it's just on Inkscape. Thank you. Ta-da. So yeah, 2 hour 15 minutes. Well, actually it was just about a 2 hour first draft. Not counting the butterfly that I messed around with first. So thank you so much for joining me, Red vs. Blue, and hope I see you around again. Also hello to any lurkers. Join me again. I'm probably going to do this the same time next Thursday. Yeah, that's it. You too. Have a good day.